playing Sean Paul on Hero Die. Ooh. Ooh, I almost got myself. Oh man, who can I play that's not gonna get me messed up? Am I not muted on my own thing? Are we gonna get backfeed? Nah, let's not do that. All right, let's see some feel goods. You want some feel goods? Let's try some feel goods. What's this? How loud is the Oh, you know, you can't even hear it because I was recording the last Hero School special episode, which I have recording from the headset. Man. Ooh, that's loud, isn't it? Let's drop the feel goods to a feel good volume. How about that? A nice feel good volume. So let's do the art stretches. You know, everything is a stretch. That's for art. We gotta reach for the sky. Anyway, you know, limber up your fingers and your wrist, baby, because you know you don't want that to get all messed up. And let's begin. Messing. What was I doing? I was doing cell shading on this guy, but because I stopped, I need to get the right color back, which is this color. It looks weird when it's not on the multiply layer, doesn't it? Let me try to remember to make the view like this. This way it's a bit more awesome. And I'm just gonna be drawing.
Or cell shading. It's not even really, like, I'm not putting lines or anything. It's not really line art, it's cell. Oh.
I don't have the mask on there. Eh, I'll put a mask on there in a little bit.
We don't need it right away, do we? Do we need it right away?
I feel like I need some dance hall in my life or something. Some reggaeton. Some booty shaking music, not chill music. What's wrong with me? It's what I need in my life. Early in the morning. It's not even that early in the morning, man. I've been up since 6. And what I've been doing is getting the latest update. Wow, is that the delay? I can see this bush I have for a head just aiming downwards. But yeah, I've been working on the next SMTT update. So the version 1.4. And I'm getting ready for a few things. You know, for one, I clarified the down rules. Right? The down condition was never within the conditions section. It was in the damage and healing part of the rule book, and that seemed to completely confuse a player that I had. Like, they must not have understood it in the way it was presented. So what I did is I just clarified it a little better. I put it in the conditions area of the book. I went to the getting beat up damage and healing section, and I hyperlinked it. I hyperlinked the references to the down condition to bring you to the down condition and the condition section. Should this whole thing just be in shadow? Like, so I figure this would be like a little dip in the two, you know? Or should this whole section just be like part of this weird... Yeah, I like it like that. I like it like that. Hey, baby. I got soul. I got soul. He's got soul, all right. He's got three of them. One, two, three. Dragon souls in the gems. Yeah, well, that's a... That is a point of the story. Not necessarily the specifics of the artwork. This is kind of repetitive, isn't it? Oh, that's right. I don't have, so I gotta actually use the keystrokes for that. And anyways. It's pretty cool.
Scale thingies right here. Gotta get them. Gotta get them.
Gotta get that. Gotta get that. I'm just going all over the place with music, aren't I? I'll adjust that in a little bit, but you gotta get like littles. Just wanna get some of this. I'm gonna adjust the cell shading after I get like the hard lines put down, because I mean he's full of scales, so these smooth lines make little to no sense, right? But I'll do that, you know, get a little
get a little scaliness up in here, and I'm gonna have a splatter light brush, and I'm gonna splatoon. Not like Splatoon, no, a Splatoon, that's what I'm gonna be doing, and,
fixing it up a bit, I'm a mess. Alright, so,
put the whole thing in shadow. Feel this humbo.
I can't talk because I don't know what to say, so I'm just gonna stay here in shade and try to rhyme, but I'm just too late because I suck at doing this stuff, not the drawing but the rhyming, so I'ma shut up. Oh, what's up? What's up? What's up? How y'all doing? I'm over here losing my mind as per usual. Don't know about y'all. I hope y'all have a very sane time. Or an insane time. Sanity is a bit overrated. Because a lot of the sane people do a lot of the craziest things now, don't they? And so before we get into my geopolitical views on how sane people are indeed the craziest in the world, I'm gonna stop it right there. Should it be like this whole, like, hold on, like this whole area, right? Like that's the one sliver by, I think I answered my own question right there. I do quite prefer that more than to what I was doing a second ago. Hey! I'm gonna use the eraser on this sucker anyway. So, bye-ow, my buddy bye-ow. Yeah, so this, the reason he has, like, a metallic hand is because during his first transformation, which you can see the fight where he had the first transformation on my YouTube channel. It's called, the Hero School Special Episode, The Betrayal. Where he transforms, and during his time in Hero School, he had an item known as the Heartseeker. The Heartseeker is a katar, not a guitar, a katar, punch dagger, that allows him to regenerate health when he uses it to attack. And then using the katar he had in his hand, he'd be quite a difficult target to take down. But let's just push that sort of almost hard geometric type thing. That's the under whatever's. Right. Anyways, so like I was saying, the katar that he had during his first transformation actually fused and became his hand and gave him a metallic claw during the first transformation. Now that was only a few days in possession of the Dragon Soul Gems. So after a few years, four in fact, which is the time skip, his transformation will be, if not complete, nearly complete. And this is the representation of that nearly complete form. What am I even listening to? I don't know, some chill music stuffs. Oh boy. Yeah, if you notice, I'm not drinking coffee, because like I was saying before, I woke up at 6 o'clock this morning. So I had all my coffee, I had breakfast, I worked on some of my SMTT rules. Both in updating the core rule set to be released for next month's update, which will be version 1.04. And after that update, well, in that update, I should say, is, I already mentioned how I clarified whatever question might have been posed for the down rule, because in SMTT, those of you who haven't played it, heroes never die. Alright, so you can only die a narrative death. So when you get dropped down to zero hit points, you become down. Like, that's the condition you gain. Now, while down, you can get back in. You have the option or opportunities to get back in the fight before you're, you know, down and out, and you can no longer continue doing your heroic thing. You need help from your allies. Well, you can continue doing your heroic thing. You just need a friend to help you along.
Help me. Oh, I want to help, but I can't do it myself. I need a helping hand.
And this is not Stitch's helping hand, but a helping hand from a friend to get you back in the fight is still possible even while down and out. Down and out. Which is all stipulated within the rules. Which is fairly clear, I believe. And so do some people who have a book. Anyways. With the new addition or alteration of down, putting in the conditions section, I had to hyperlink it from its current section in the book. That way it's easier to reference what exactly happens when you go down. I also implemented the, hey Brian, what's up, brother? Good for you after afternoon-ish, evening, noon thing. But yeah. I implemented something new in preparation for the Golem Armor rules that I was also working on this morning. Golem Armor is pretty much the mecha rule set for SMTT. When that's released, it's going to give the option to be to pilot a sort of mechanized machine called Golem Armor. And it's going to be only available to the small races, because they don't get enough love right now, to be honest. Like, I don't think anybody's really said that the small races suck or anything, but I feel that I just didn't give, like, the gnomes and the halflings quite enough attention and give them quite enough appeal to be played when people could play, you know, ogres, oni, yetis, tiger people, werewolves. You know, there's a lot of stuff that I think is more appealing, but yet they're still like the oldies and goodies, you know what I'm saying? So I've been wanting to do it for a while. So I've been working on it for a while. It's making progress. But like I was saying, I wanted to get the new rules in the core rulebook in preparation, because I'm bringing back another oldie but goodie: damage reduction. Alright? So SMTT will have both damage resistance, damage immunity, and finally damage reduction. Which requires a bit of math. Just a small bit of math. But I have faith that simple subtraction won't be that difficult. And basically damage reduction is exactly what it sounds like. It reduces a set amount of damage of a set type of damage. So I already sort of had damage reduction in the book when it comes to the heavy armor, no, not the heavy armor, the armor master feat. Depending on whether the armor master is wearing heavy, medium, or light armor, they have damage reduction against bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing weapons. The amount of damage reduction depends on their awesome power and how heavy the armor they're wearing is. Now, it was never written as damage reduction. I didn't specifically state,
well, you know, have Armor Master gives you damage reduction.
I never stated that. It was just, you know, you reduce damage, incoming, bludgeoning, piercing, slashing damage by this set amount. And that was it. It was really, really sort of, I don't know, undersimplified? But it was just a simplified statement because it was the only thing in the book that really gave damage reduction. But with the eventual integration of Golem armor, Golem armors will have armor plating, and said armor plating will give damage reduction. So I wanted to make sure that those rules are specifically stated and clarified. Why can't I get that piece? There we go. So the damage reduction rules are now in the book. And they'll be released with the version 1.04 update. Get these nails looking sufficiently gnarly. Because they're not nails, they're claws. Claw your face off. Well, he can. He can claw faces off and rip wings off. I'm sorry, Brian. I remembered what happened. I shouldn't be putting you through that turmoil again. Poor McCallus. Having to relive that horrendous moment. Oh, man. So, yeah. Damage reduction is being implemented in the SMTT core rules. What else? What else did I do? Actually, I've got my update because I was just working on it. Additions and changes. I added pack tactics to the Evil Tour traits. The full round action. The full round action was added in preparation for the martial artist. Also in preparation of the martial artist, I revisited the unarmed combat rules, better clarifying the standard attack methods available to all SMTT characters. I also added curb stomp and expanded the rules for climbing a giant creature. Why is that spelled creature? Creature. Creature. Not creature. Creature. Yeah, I'm not gonna... I wasn't the one who stated it. That's on Mike that he ripped off your wings. I mean, it makes perfect canonical sense that he went to rip off your wings. But, yeah, really, like, I don't think you should be blaming me for that. First off, I wasn't the one that melted Killian Freed, stole his gems, and sold them, which started the whole mess. Regardless of who, you know, responsibility or whatever, I'm not the one that did that. Give him some sort of ripples and stuff. He's like, I'm not strong. have to zoom out a little bit because those wings. You know, that's only because that's not your true form. Your true form wasn't damaged. If anything in your true form was damaged, like if you would have ripped your arm off instead, or if you would have been in your bird form, that would have sucked. Because your arms, your wings are your arms when you're fully transformed into a bird. So if you would have ripped the wing off in that form, you would have lost your arm. And that would have been gone. Which, you know, to be honest, like to be fully and completely honest, would have been really cool. Like a one-armed Michaelis. It would have been messed up, but really cool. Because, like, you could eventually get a prosthetic limb. And who knows where you could take the prosthetic limb. You know, what kind of role play you would want to add to that. Trying to see an actual character with a prosthetic limb. The only one who's had an arm ripped off and been cool with it was Saheb when he's when he played. Well, look, Saheb played Dwarfington, got his arm ripped off, then reprised Dwarfington several times with the missing limb. Okay? Yes, it's horrible, but it makes for a great story. You know? Especially for a hero. Like, we already know Michaelis. Michaelis is a hero. Right? He may not be fully hero yet, but he working it. You know he's gonna be that full-blown epic, you know. Save the people, hero. That's what he's going for. I know it. If Michaelis falls to the evildoers' side of things, I'll be sufficiently surprised. That would catch me a little off guard. Holy cow, these wings! These flipping wings! What was I thinking when I did these wings? Jeez. All sorts of weirdness and just golly, man. Oh yeah, B. I got into that incarnate thing, but I gotta set up a new account. I'm gonna check it out when I get a chance. Maybe after the stream or something. You doubt who would? Wait. I missed that. When did you see? I'm all off balance, off base. You doubt who would what? What are you doubting over here? What's this doubt I hear about? Oh, you doubt he'll fall to the bad guy's side. Yeah, my brain just caught up. My brain wasn't catching up, and it just did. I got you now, man. I got you. But yeah, I'd be really surprised if that was the case. Became a bad guy. Just for what? I don't know. It'd have to be like one of those things where you become a bad guy because you have to become a bad guy to be the good guy. You know, like the Dark Knight. I'll take the fall. Freaking Dark Knight voice. I'll take the fall. They need a hero they can believe in. See, that's not even Dark Knight. That's too much thud on that voice. No, you know why? You're gonna harass me. You're gonna harass me, Brian. You're gonna be... If I open up a hangout, I'm joining a hangout with you, you're gonna be like, do this and that and the other. And you're gonna make me turn off my music, and I'm gonna bug out more, because you know how I bug out when there's no music. Look at me. I'm starting to bug out just at the notion of not having music. Golly, man. Oh. Look, I'm just gonna add the sort of weird, that weird ripply, leathery stuff in the shading. Because, I don't know, it looks like it belongs there. Larger brush, so it's a little bit more random. I'm just making a mess of things. Hold on. Yeah, right, you won't harass me. We'll see. Oh, hold on. Now I gotta actually set up a hangout. Oh my gosh, Brian. What's with this privilege? Like, this is Irish privilege? Let's see. Where is this? Blue. Oh, I gotta go to here. So I can do this. And send you that. Because, you know, you wanna harass me. I gotta put away my beautiful hair. My beautiful hair. Oh. Yeah, it is Irish privilege. Oh God, it's terrible. I'm saving the wrong thing over here. I hear Ninja coming in. I'll mute my mic in the hangout. Or not. I don't know. Because I know you're going to be like, oh, that music. Cool. I'll really, like, I'll lose it without music, man. You know this. I need my tunes. It's not right if I don't have my tunes, man. But, yeah, what up, man? Yeah, I saw some of your comments, man. You really going into like art science and shit with that, man. I'll do what I can. Like I haven't had a chance to actually mess about, because I never made an account, like a separate account. I always played with Incarnate using my Facebook account. Yeah, for the latest build. But you know, I gotta set that up. I haven't set that up yet because I've been a little bit busy. But yeah, I'll definitely want to play around with that. From what I saw, there's a lot of nice little things. You know, one thing that I noticed off the bat, which is probably just a, you know, an issue of, you know, of time, like it's probably going to end up doing it anyway, is that in a lot of the assets that I've seen so far that have been posted to that whatever that is, that chat thingy, that there's the shading on the buildings is a bit discontinuous. Okay. Yeah, well, the thing that is most glaring to me upon first glance is some of the art assets for the new buildings, they have cast shadows, right? But not all of them have cast shadows. That's what I mean about it's a little, you know, it's not really contiguous. It's if they're gonna have cast shadows, I believe they should all have cast shadows, because it makes sense. You know, it's more like they're a little bit more represented as being part of the map, part of the world, rather than icons. You know, and the icons that they already have, which is basically like the line art cities. You know, I mean, those, of course, they don't need shadows, they're line art. So if you're gonna go the full isometric, drop that, you know, cast that shadow, man. And at first glance, that's what I've noticed. Yeah, the cast shadow. Yeah. I mean, I don't know why the artist, you know, would do for some like that. That seems like maybe, I don't know, maybe if multiple artists, there's lack of communication, lack of style guide. Yeah, but you've been the only dude who used Incarnate, a cartography software, to make actual pictures. So, you know, expecting people to be on that level is a little selfish. I mean, you were just, weren't we just talking about how, like, how I judge products and, you know, I'm kind of unrealistic because I do the craziness that I do. And I really shouldn't be judging other people by what I do. Even though I think, you know, it's all it is just using tools that are available to you. You know, it's not, I don't know, man. You know, I'm always really hypercritical of myself. But to tell you the truth, I don't think what I'm doing is all that difficult. Like, it is all that, it's only a big deal because nobody else does it. You know, if, yeah. Yeah. I would love. I. Which one? Yeah. Yeah, that's what the Heartseeker became. Remember the Heartseeker? Give me a second to see which brush this was. Was it a brush? No, it was a oil paint. Or was it? Yeah, it was this. Runny color spray, right? That wasn't it. Is it this? It was, but that's a little. Nah. That it would drop. Oh, what the? Okay, hold on. Trying to, okay, I think this was it. Cause I don't want to do all the scaling, you know, like how I usually do when I do like scale textures like that. This is a lot. This is a lot. So I want to take a shortcut today. I've been in this sucker for a little bit. Oh, it would look so worth it. It would look amazing. But this is not, I mean, this is not for a book. This is not for anything special. This is not a high quality print or anything. I gotta do it from this far. It only looks cool this far out. I gotta be careful how much of it I actually use though. Yeah. Yeah, I know what that is. Get over the spray. Just want to make sure that the fact that he's a scaly beast is represented, you know? Instead of all this smooth, you know, smooth shading, you wouldn't have smooth shading on a scaly beast. Even if the scales are very fine. Oh, my allergies are starting to come. That's the sound my face makes when I got allergies. Let's see if I just get a little bit here and there, right? Yeah, I know what he is. So you don't gotta worry about me trying to figure out what he is. You gotta worry about you guys figuring out what he is. Or what it is. Yeah, well, you know, stuff happens. Holy cow. Yeah, stuff happens. Yeah. Has not been stopped in the past 4 years. So. This is Knuckles. After Knuckles, I think I'm gonna work on this thing. I'll give it a minute to catch up. I'm gonna have a sip. Cause you know there's a delay. Yeah, since I'm doing a lot more work on the Golem Armor. Golem Armor. And mounts, right? Mounts, I think I'm starting to do an alternate rule set for an animal companion so that other people can have animal companions similar to the ranger. And the ranger can build an animal companion, but because of all the ranger's features, the maneuvers, the companion mastery level, it's just going to be better in every way, right? And I believe if I do it that way, it'll also benefit from the mount rules in case you want to make, like, you know, like the Lone Ranger, you know, the Lone Ranger type character with, like, the horse that does freaking everything and is always there, or like Zorro, his horse is always there for him. Like, one of those type characters. I think it'll... Alright, it'll be like, it'll be a little bit more characterful, you know? Instead of just having to be the Amarok and that's it, and then you just doing your best to reskin it afterwards, you know, I'm creating the rules so that you can create an entire variety, right? And after those rules are finalized, I'm going to create a listing, you know, bears, polar bears, pig bears, wyverns, cockatrices maybe, thunderbirds, different types of horses, maybe different horse breeds, elephants, giant jackals, whatever. I'll do a whole slew of them. Well, that's the thing. Like, you know how you have so much customization within the Saturday morning tabletop classes? I want to share that level of customization when it comes to, you know, creating your getting items and gear. That way, when you get your items and gear, it could be like when you mentioned the old school D&D cartoon, right? The items they got, you know, one guy, all he got was a shield, you know, that was his item. The girl got that pole, that was her item, you know? So you have that, this sort of, you know, Thundercats. You know what the items were in Thundercats, right? Yeah, you had the staff, right? That was, I think, Chitara's. Yeah. They had, like, gadgets, I think. They're more gadget-driven. Panthro was the man. So, yeah, man. So that's what that's what I want to go for, right? I want to go for a little bit of that. You know, bring that back. Because when you make your RPG characters nowadays, you don't really have, you know, it's really hard to be that special. And it's usually only because you skin something. You're pretending to be that special. There's nothing supporting your character actually being that little special snowflake that you want to be. So, to support that, I think that's what I want to do, right? So that's what I'm trying to do. And even if I add the animal companion rules so that everyone can have animal companions, the hero's best friend background and the ranger are still better than anything else. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Get a huge bird mount. All right. I think that might be it. Oh. What do you think? Awesome-tacular. That's awesome-tacular. It's not just awesome. It's awesome tech. Oh, I could paint in white. I'm a dummy. This will actually help break up that silhouette. Oh my goodness. Why did my brain not remember I could do some craziness like this? Okay, let me go over it. Cause I still see hard lines. right? So I want to break up the hard lines. And now I can break up the hard lines. What's wrong with me? Why didn't I remember this? I may not be as awake as I thought I was. I'm asleep of the mind. Waking of the body and asleep of the mind. I was ill prepared for the task in hand. But I find myself... Don't laugh yet. I'm not done being silly. Don't laugh yet and make me stop. Jeez, man. No, put Saber away. Put Saber away. We don't need the Saber voice.
Oh no, 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 no.
Just nothing. Just mumbling. What language is he speaking? None. He's just mumbling. Wonder if that's what a goblin sounds like, but in a higher pitched voice. Yeah, rat gut. That was his. Cuz, you know, you had that crystal caretaker invading his mind space. Goblins, yeah. Yeah. Oh man. Like, I got way too many characters, man. Like in this alone, there was a Skull Crusher, the tribal necromancer, right? There was Ratgut, Sweet Tooth, Melissa, what was his pet has a name too. I forget his pet's name right now. But his pet Pig Bear. Yeah. Sweet Tooth already also has a pet Pig Bear. I don't remember her name, man. Like, it completely escapes me. Oh, how did I miss you, man? I need to say Tallulah. Yeah, Tallulah. She's got a big tutu, yeah. Tallulah wears a tutu. And he treats his ladies nice. Even when they're non-humanoid. So you got Tallulah, Sweet Tooth, there was Killian Freed, Senka Kraus, the Jelly Father, the Beetle Knight, Chief runs this joint. You don't remember? Yeah, that's the one Saber slayed like 100 of his turkeys in one thing. He's the were-turkey. You don't remember the were-turkey?
Sankayu.
Yeah. Well, that wasn't allowed to happen because, you know, the route the children chose to take. No, you guys left. Nobody wanted to let you give the gems back to Killian Freed, you know. They were all talking crap about it. And man, this has gotta sound weird. Just for you ladies and gents watching, I've got Brian, my boy Brian, in a hangout on the headset talking to me. So I'm not talking to myself. Which is something I do tend to do sometimes anyway, but this time I'm not. Just so y'all know. And if you want to, you know, type whatever down, ask whatever questions, try to find out what in the hell I'm rambling on about, just feel free. But yeah, what happened was that the kids, as a whole, right? As a whole, you guys all decided to basically give away Belladonna. It's basically what you guys decided to do. Just give away Belladonna to Sweet Tooth, because he is oh so trustworthy. And I say that because I know none of you trust him. None of you trust him. You guys hate him with a passion. Every last one of you hates Sweet Tooth. But yeah. So, Sweet Tooth got Belladonna with him. You guys went that direction first, which wasn't the initial plan. So there's that issue. That issue. Not a good day for you guys. So many bad things happened. Yeah. Nobody really worried about Sweet Tooth. Y'all all like, we don't trust him, we don't like him, and that's it. Like, it was left at that. Yeah. Yeah. Actually, I don't want the 4 effect line, but... Well, that's what... that's what ended up happening. Like... Yeah. Sorry, I should not be laughing at your pain like this, but I am. but it's all I got. I know, this time it's me being a pain to you. Yeah, I'm sorry for counting on that, because you know, because I was like, he wanted to do his redemption episode, right? And I'm like cool, but I was like, I don't know. This is Lucas Loenkai we're talking about here. So I don't know if he's gonna like redeem anything, right? So I was like, all right, I'm gonna put the redemption episode with a question mark, because, you know, this is who we talking about. And then when he started doing the good guy thing for a moment, I was like, oh no. I was like, what am I gonna do now? Cinema good. I was like, I don't know what to do now. Let's get rid of this thing. Cause I'm not doing it I'm gonna do it on a separate layer. But yeah, like, he was changing his ways. And I'm like, oh snap, this thing's gonna be so weird. This title. But he didn't disappoint. He just sunk his teeth into the greed. You. Now I'm just being silly. Soft. Like that soft light. That's what I like. I like that soft light, man. Do I like that soft light? I don't know if I like that soft light. Probably. Several, in fact. You're taking out all your aggression on the poor Talismat. Yeah. You just smited the mess out of that poor Talismot. Who, I'm going to be real, right? Initially, the Talismot was going to fight you with his fists and using his, as a scare tactic. And, there's a way to paint with transparency on this. I just don't know what it is. No, there's a way to paint with transparency. You know? I've seen it online. Like, I've seen people do it online and mention it. I personally do not know how. And since I'm personally trying to do something right now, it kind of sucks. I want to paint with transparency. I just don't know how. Oh, man. Take a break. Stretch them wrists. You know what I'm saying, man? You know what I'm saying? Initially, no. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Like, the Talismot was, you know, he really thought he had it in the bag. You know what I'm saying? So, all he was going to do was, you know, a little showboating. Shove you guys around and try to drop you both to your beat-up threshold. Because this was not a real fight. I wasn't trying to destroy you guys, you know? This wasn't an evildoer trying to end any notion of your heroism. It was just this guy trying to be like, yeah, you guys ain't nothing. I gotta canonize you, basically. Right? And the both of you hardcore laid into him. So laid into him. Or he's gonna try. But, oh man, you guys laid into him. And all he did, like, one shot, had he hit Lucas twice with his pistol, Lucas would have been out. Right? As a matter of fact, had he not been blinded while he was hitting you, because you were still brought down to your beat-up threshold, right? Oh, you weren't? Oh, ooh, okay. Because he might have stopped right then and there. You know? Because the whole point is that he was going to go for your beat-up thresholds. Boy. This canvas is so ridiculously big because it kind of needs to be. Because his wings are so ridiculously... Yeah, they take up so much room. I'm trying to get this canvas down as close as I can. He's got four wings. So I don't know. You better hope he doesn't have like a wing buffet attack, like summoning cyclones. Whoosh, you know. Oh yeah, that'd be awesome.
Why, thank you for the inspiration.
Ha, cackling of desperation. Yeah. Oh. Alright. So, turn off the background so I could put him somewhere, sometime, somehow. Knuckles, this is the beast, formerly known as Knuckles, now known as hashtag pain. That's what he is. Zoom in so you don't have to deal with the, he's got a weaponized tail. So that's the beast, formerly known as Knuckles. Get a nice close-up of him and not all that wingage. So there you go. Let that sink in. To coin a phrase from the Smoking RP Gamer, who is in no way, shape, or form responsible for the existence of this creature, which he actually is, let that sink in. Josh. The Smoking RP Gamer. That was his channel. That's, you know, that's what the icon I drew for him actually says. You don't. You're not that perceptive. I'm perceptive, baby. So, let me save that. Close it when it's done. Close. Well, is it saved? Yeah. Oh, let me, I'll. Hello. Okay. It's taking a little bit. It wasn't actually saving. New. All right, bro. Music. Just being silly. let me stop being so silly. Oh wait, hold on. That sounded like kind of cool. See, that's nice. All right, maybe I'll work on this golem armor over here. So, for those of you watching, golem armor is basically the mecca for Saturday Morning Tabletop, which is this, what's the Armor Master? Where's the cover? It's up here. This is the cover of the game that I created called Saturday Morning Tabletop. It's current rules version 1.03, soon to be 1.04, updated next month. But anyway, it's still mid-alpha, early beta. Not even early beta. Screw it. Mid-alpha stages for the big, bulky armors. And I like it to be big and bulky because I think it's funnier that way. And I think they're cool. So because I think they're cool, I draw them big and bulky. So that's what I do. This right here is supposed to represent a gnome, which is a small size category character. They're the ones that pilot these things. Small characters. Medium characters would be about that big. Medium characters would be about there. Large characters be about there, which is the same overall height as this thing. Even though the head heights probably should have a head like that big. Then his body. That'd probably be a little bit more accurate to the proportions of a gnome. But anyway, I need a new thing now because I need to draw this thing. But I digress. This is not what I wanted to do here today. Welcome back. No. This one is large. Yeah, not every golem armor is going to be large. The weaker golem armors, the trading golem armors, are going to be medium-sized, but no smaller than medium. See if I can pull up the what you calls real quick. Core rules, PDS, searching. No, this is just the artwork. Yeah, sure, you appear on that screen. So I've got quite a few pages of stuff right now. Ultimately, the idea is this is how the golden armors are going to be laid out. You know, they're going to have their tier. Jinsil, Gamil, and Belgron are from the Biggles family, right? They're going to be separated. The core builds are going to be separated between the three major gnome families. The Gainers, the Sprockets, and the Biggles. I'm working on the Biggles right now. Right? And, do I have it written down here? Yeah. See, the Jinsil is medium-sized, and it's made between tiers 1, 2, and 3. Right? The tier of the golem armor is going to be important. Because it's going to be, a core factor in deciphering some of the golem armor's actual abilities. Much in the same way as I'm going to do the mount rules, where I have, like, here are all the construction rules, right? So it's like a character construction, a character building session for a piece of gear. But I'm going to have a listing of pre-built, and custom golem armors. Just to start off with, so you know, like, oh, I can get this, I can get that. You know, and if your DM wants to create brand new types of golem armors that can be purchased or awarded, then they have the tools to do so. But the Jinsil is medium, the Gamil and Belgron are large. Gamil is between tiers 2 to 4, which is kind of like middle, you know, that's mid-grade, standardized. And then the heavy golem armor is tier 4 to 5. But I haven't done the numeric stuff over here. But I will, I'll get there. You know, I gotta go back to the actual gear creation rules. I haven't been there in a bit. I don't know. What happened? Yeah. I think multiple are possible. I just don't know how to set that up. Well, there is no RPG. There's no RPG for creative. Because, like, I'm in creative right now. And comics is a community within creative. Because I'm being creative right now, you know? I'm drawing. Yeah, the only RPG tag that I know of is actually Dungeons and Dragons. And I'm not doing Dungeons and Dragons. Like, if I'm running a game and I do it on Twitch, that'll be my only option. To select it as Dungeons and Dragons. But I'm just drawing. So regardless of what's what, you know, I'm drawing. So I'm going to be in creative.
But trust me, on the sunscreen.
Oh, you typing kind of fast there, buddy. You typing like it's an emergency.
And then we get this little thing here because it makes
was this it? Yeah, that was the one, not the one I had. All right. There we go. Yeah. So we'll go, you know, we'll handle that today. Oh, I gotta make, I don't think I have Abe as a character build. And I know I gotta make a character build for Abe for you. If you're gonna be playing Abe, like, as his sort of NPC backup. I mean, you know. Then again, I don't know how rational any of El Pantera's actions are going to be either. But. Damn it. My allergies be just messing me up. Yeah, this is way better suited to that. Way way better, because it's like, you know, it's just way better, way better for it. It's like everything that I want this to do, pretty much it does better than Photoshop. You know, the only thing that it's not going to really do better is the cartography stuff. But, hey. I could live with that. Yeah, I'm learning how to use it a little bit better. So that's how that thing looks so far. It's got that massive sword in one hand. Boy. You don't want to mess with him. You what happened? Oh, hell yeah, man. They're gonna be a blast, baby. I just gotta get the prerequisites for the bond, right? What, a specific one? What would you want to do with a specific one? Why does it make sense? When these gnomes are pretty much global. Sprockets. Sprockets, gainers, biggles, and that's it. Those are the major. Those aren't the only families, man. But they're the major families and the forerunners of technology. If I wanted to have one in Himmelstar, I would have been the one that said it. You're the one that wants it in Himmelstar. Don't try to be putting words in my mouth. Why you gotta be all up in my mouth, Brian? That's not cool. It's a very private place. Shouldn't be there. Only food, drink, and toothpaste go there. That's it. No Brian's allowed. Damn it! No Brian's allowed. No, definitely no Brian's allowed. You do not fit the criteria of food, drink, or toothpaste. No. Saber needs to retire. He needs to be a retired child already. He needs to be. We don't need to see any more Saber ever. He's too much. What will bad guys begin to do? when they can't handle that kid. Yeah, when I get to releasing that, definitely. I gotta curve this. Sometimes I wonder, like, if I should start trying to do vector lines instead. You know? Yeah. You know vector art, right? I don't know if it's possible. It must be possible here. But in, like, Photoshop, it's like the pen tool would do it. You know? It's kind of like solid black lines. That they're not pixels. So they don't have any real anti-aliasing. They don't blur. I mean, I have... But it was many years, much like many other things, that was many years ago. Like, I messed with it when Illustrator was kind of new, or newish, I guess. I remember loving it. It was really cool. Like, it was hard. Like, now, Illustrator is completely different, right? Like, you could draw your vector line with a tablet. I don't know if they had that feature before, but I didn't know about it. Nobody at where I worked knew about that. They were doing everything in like Friskets, you know, just cut out shapes. They wouldn't draw any lines. They wouldn't go like this with lines. They'd use like a tool to create like that, and then a tool to create circles, you know. And then a tool to create like a curve line, and then like in that circle have like, you know, rectangles or whatever. And like that's how they would draw their pictures and start animating. Speaking about animating, man, I want to animate something. You know, but then I'd have to go back to Photoshop. So you could show me like what's what, and I'm like, I don't want to go back to Photoshop. I want to rely on this, because I really want to learn it. You know. I know. It's like that temptation. You know what I'm saying? So I either gotta give in or resist that temptation. Oh, you would say that, wouldn't you? Son of a gun. I hate when I press the wrong button. Or I don't press the right button. Or I press the right button too many times. Yeah, like, I might, you know, you already know, I might stream, like, 3 hours or 4 hours or an hour, and then go and draw, like, another 5 hours that day off stream. Because drawing is life for me. more so than breathing. You can tell because I'm asthmatic. I don't breathe that much. I should not be joking about that. Oh my gosh, Becky, look at the size of her butt. Let's see how this is actually looking. I've been trying to get used to constantly flipping. When I first did this, I wrote Gnome Pilot backwards because I forgot it was flipped. Yeah, it, fresh eye. Yeah, well, for me, the best part of flipping is if I wanted to do a line like this, I'll flip it and then do the same line over here. So it's a lot easier on my hand. You know? It's a lot easier on the hand. That's why I wanted to get used to using it, because I wasn't used to using it. Now I'll flip again and then just do this chest. And it becomes so much easier. It's like, oh! Why are you making fun of me? Always with the harassment. Yeah, you're like, this is harassment. Oh, now you're gonna mess with my funk, huh? You gonna listen to this funky song? You gonna? I could tell by that gasp. You gasped. That's not cool. Chew. Yeah. On a full-blown campaign? I don't know. I would like to see him reprise that character of his, that gunslinger. He was like really just getting the hang of using the maneuvers. You know? I pretend very well. Like, when I was doing Just Angie, I was like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, I gotta concentrate. What am I doing? I'm not doing anything. Everything I'm doing is wrong. And it turned out to be okay. But I felt like, oh, I don't like it. It's just that I'm really critical about my work. I just don't, I'm not the person that goes, okay, everything I do sucks. You know, there's people that do that about their artwork, and I'm not one of them. I suffer in silence is what I do. Did I do that right? I don't know. It's right enough for now, I guess. Yeah, she was watching the stream when I did it. Yeah. I was about to say, like, when she was watching it, She said it didn't seem like I was having a hard time drawing the beige. She said I made it look easy. I'm like, I don't know how, but thanks. Because, yeah, every artist really is, every good artist is their worst critic. You know, because you know, what am I doing? I'm doing this. Like, I remember back in the day, right? When I was in high school, there used to always be, like, contests. And, but not, like, official contests. It was more like, you can't draw. I draw better than you. Yeah, look at this. Nah, man, I was doing this, man. That's cool, but I was doing this one, and this is how it came out. Oh, you think you're nice. You know, like, that kind of stuff. I guess, right? Yeah, it's very aggressive. Very, very aggressive. But that's kind of like how it was, right? And I loved it. Because it was like, you found your... You got to find people to be cool with. Because there were people who thought they were good and weren't. There were people who thought they were good and were. But their attitudes were just poisonous. And it was very easy to tell who's who. You know, and you got to hang out with a lot of people, see a lot of art, practice a lot of different styles. Like, I swear, back in the day, I had this anime style that I really, really liked to draw. And I don't know what happened to it. I just, you know, no practice. You know, 14 years in a brick and mortar job without practicing my art, I lost that. And I used to love doing that too, man. Like, it wasn't really anime, but it was just anime enough for me. Now, the closest thing that I have to that old style is this, SMTT. But it's not quite that. But who knows, you know, art is all about practice, so the more I draw, the more I get back, the better I get, you know. Except for that painting stuff. I can't paint to save my butt. Like, I've been watching, there's this girl, Voodoo Vow, right? She's kind of silly on the stream. But, man, she can paint. It's not fair. It's not fair, man. I want to be able to do that, and I can't. I'm gonna need, like, years of practice. Or maybe that's just not for me, you know? Like, I understand forms. Like, when I sculpt, right? I sculpt in ZBrush. So, you know, dimensional planes, where things sit. I understand all of that. Just not when I'm trying to paint something. Just not when I'm trying to paint something. It all goes away. Oh, man. Shut up. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm making lines. That's all I'm doing. What are you talking about? You could paint, dude. Yeah, but you could paint. So, shut up. You got that. You got them painting skills, man.
You know, I think I like doing this. Like, I think this is already going to help my artwork, right? I know you mentioned, you know, it's good to flip the canvas, to get a fresh eye, to pick out your mistakes a little bit better and everything. And I flip the canvas to make it easier for me to draw. Like, for my hand, so I don't get cramped up so much. And I only just started doing that, but I think because I flip it so much to make it easier for me to draw and not trying to remember, oh, I gotta remember to flip it to check how my artwork's going, it's becoming more and more of a habit because it's like, that line is kind of hard for me to twist my arm like this. So instead I flip it to make it easier to do the line, I think it's already starting to improve how I do things. Just as a consequence. Which is interesting. Amo? Yeah? Flip it, smack it, rub it down? Nope. Nope. What? I was... Why are you distracting me? You're talking about flipping it, smacking it, and rubbing it down. Yeah, you should stop doing that. You should stop harassing me. Why do you have to harass me so much, Brian? I don't know why. What forever did I do to you?
Golem armor. You do not want to mess with me. I am a golem armor pilot. Go, go, golem armor!
That noise did not come out of my mouth. I'm getting some water is what I'm doing. Oh, this music sounds like... like you don't want to do drugs and listen to it. You know? Like it's like whoop, 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 whoop. Like you don't want to drink. You don't want to be on any controlled substances whatsoever. Or you'll really start to lose it. You'll bug out. For real. I can't believe they would make something like this. Oh my gosh. What do you mean? Were you guys like fighting character builds when I wasn't around? Yeah, I gotta get. Oh, so you did fight. Okay. Is that when is that when he decided to change Sir William Gold again to make him an arcane warrior? A knight. That's interesting. That's the problem with Saturday morning tabletop. Things are just good. You know, there are classes that are just good. Look, Look, it's not his fault. He was smitten by Melissa. It's not his fault. I think Loki's worse because he does it on purpose. Look, Sir William Gold, right? Sir William Gold was his character during the beta campaign, right? And he started off playing Sir William Gold like a good guy, like a hero. He really did. It's just, after the implementation of Sweet Tooth, that was it. That was it. Like, he went from, yeah. He lost all control. You know? That's what happened. He lost control of his character. You know, he lost all his sense of heroism because of Sweet Tooth. And he just started making bad decision after bad decision. And it wasn't as a direct result of Sweet Tooth. You know, and then Sweet Tooth did that one stupid plan that should have never worked. And did. And somehow he pulled it off because somebody thought they were crazier than they were. Or you know, that's what the excuse is. You know, I had levels of insanity, so there was only one level. And he never roleplayed his insanity. So I don't really know what happened there, but is that the right pen? That's not the right pen. This is the right pen. Anyway, that's what happened. So once Sweet Tooth got into the picture, Sir William Gold fell apart. You say that. Sweet Tooth got the better of you guys in hero school, too. And he didn't even do nothing. He didn't even, like, he was beat by you guys in a fight. In the fight, you guys choked him out. You put him to sleep. You did all sorts of, y'all were just mean to him. To be honest, like, the way y'all treated Sweet Tooth was just nasty. You know, throwing your weight around. Hey. Like, I just kind of felt like that was everyone's response to Sweet Tooth. Hey. Don't make me put you to sleep again. Oh, man. Yeah, it did play out very nicely for Sweet Tooth. It was all just like opportunistic, really. Cause it was when Knuckles decided it was a smart idea to force Sweet Tooth into some form of, like, he's gonna tie him down and throw them all off your skyship. Right? And, you know, Sweet Tooth, he couldn't resist because his awesome power wasn't nearly high enough to contest the grappling abilities of Knuckles, right? So he's like making a fool of himself trying to resist, so he can't resist. Meanwhile, Belladonna, yep, baby, oh. Yeah. Oh. Oh. Yeah. Just set that up for him. That's what happened. Yeah, which it wasn't necessary, but all right, I need to. Yeah, you really did. Yeah, it kind of is a pretty good thing.
I didn't notice that. Let me obsess.
Oh, that voice. If anybody heard that voice, they'd die. It's instant. He could just be like, no. No, stop it! Ah, my ears, they bleed! Yeah, I know you were telling me about that. Well, you know, sometimes I think I'd like to think of you as what? No. Not even gonna go there. So, hey, Ryan, how you doing?
There's only monsters, yeah, okay, so what we're gonna do is gonna go and be heroes and save people from the monsters. Holy cow, the monsters hit harder than we thought. Run! No, help me. I need to get out of here.
We'll see. How could it make... Like, what are you talking about? How could it make matters worse for anybody involved? For this, I don't know for what you're talking about. Why would you even say such a thing? You guys had an advantage? When was this? Yeah. That could be seen as disadvantageous. But maybe it doesn't even matter. Maybe it doesn't matter. Maybe they don't care if you get help. Like, go get your help. Nothing you can do can stop us now. They gotta do that Mandark laugh. They gotta do the Mandark laugh.
It was a ruse! They never wanted Peladon in the first place. They required control of Dalton Castle. Ah.
I don't know, did you already, did the Saber already have a bond? So in other words, he has a bond that's not released, and he wants a bond that's not even finished. Just touch the button. I should have known that if you did anything with Saber, it would revolve around randomly touching buttons. You've been listening to too much Chemical Brothers or Daft Punk's? Oh crap, I forget. Some push the button. Never mind, I messed my whole joke up. It's all over. That's a good outline size. What? How am I cheating?
I should not be using the tools supplied to me by this program, is what you are saying.
You're cheating! You're using capabilities that you wouldn't have if you weren't using the program.
But I am using the program, and this is why. Really? Digital art is cheating. You know, digital art I don't think is cheating. Simply because, okay, well, you're right, it's just a tool. But you could tell digital art from a mile away. You know when something's digital, it has a different look, a different aesthetic. As a matter of fact, it's very difficult to get that sort of same feel in digital as like pen and paper, right? Like, I can't get the same line qualities at all. I can't get the same line qualities because I'm way more self-conscious. I'm way less confident. And I've been doing digital art for years, and I still have that sense of, ugh, I don't, you know. Like, one of the reasons why I like Manga Studio so much is because it gets the sort of a line quality that I like, that I could never get with Photoshop. You know? But it's still not the same. It's not the same as a Sharpie. You know, doing what I'm doing now is like the best compromise. But the lines aren't the same. You know? They're just not, and they never will be. Unless, well, I say never will be. I'm lying. If you get that new stuff they have out, that like you put the paper on, you put a paper on a tablet and you just draw. That's coming close. But then again, there's also like the reason brush packs are popular is because they've done something with the brushes that mimics, you know, some form of randomality. Like, you know, traditional mediums always have that, your tools have a bit of unpredictability to them, and you learn to predict the unpredictable nature. And then you control that. Hell yeah. You know, the way the watercolor in here seems to act similar to watercolor. Like, I'm not a very big watercolor artist, so I can't be like the end all be all. I don't know what I'm talking about, but but like, as a for instance, the watercolor in here is nice. It has like a nice way of mixing and stuff. But when I see other people who actually paint in watercolor, it's not the same at all. You know, there's a specific type of randomness that you're not getting. You know, they're like, in watercolor, right? As a traditional artist using watercolor, you could always add more water to change how that whole thing behaves, you know. Like, I've seen watercolor artists that they do backgrounds by simply putting a bit of water, a bit of color, and then adding water to it and letting it bleed outwards into the paper, you know. And it's sort of a bit of controlled chaos, but you're not getting that digitally. Like, can't, like, how the hell? I forgot to be drawing like this so everybody sees more instead of seeing all my little mini windows and stuff. Anyway, I gotta take a little break, do my little stretches. Before everything gets too stiff. But that's where I'm at right now with this this golem knight, this golem armor. What was that? Oops. That's right. That's the way the actual picture really is. Oh yeah, you know it. You know it. He's gonna get in there and just be like, kring, fighting and stuff. Who knows? He probably has like a hand cannon upgrade to his left hand. Cause you know, it's already in the core rules, right? The prosthetic limbs and the golem armors aren't out yet, but the rules for integrating gnome technology is already in the core rulebook. So some of the gnome crafted items can be purchased and upgraded into your stuff, right? Let me close magic. Let me open gear. Open the gear tables. Weapon tables. Simple. Martial melee. Gnome crafted weapon table, right? While we're taking this break, let's look at this stuff. Let's see. Fist weapon. Loading. Special. None of these. Short bow. Let's go to the range ones then. Yeah. So like this. The bolt cannon has the upgrade feature, right? Meaning it could become a part of like a transformable weapon for a prosthetic limb, or a transformable weapon integrated into a suit of golem armor. And what a bolt cannon is, it's a Gatling like crossbow bolt thrower. So that's an upgrade. The arcane cannon can be used as an upgrade. What else? Hand cannon can be an upgrade. You got hit with a hand cannon, so you know those things hurt. You know, and that's what the gear I have so far. So imagine like arcane cannon. What the hell? He's got an Arcana drive as his engine, and his arm transforms. Pow, pow, pow. You know. Hey God Girk. So what up, lurkers? How you doing, lurkers? I'm more like this. I'm shooting. That's what shooting is with fist. Never mind. I'm gonna go back to drawing this thing before I get all confused. I don't even know what that is. I just call that the lighthouse thing. It's got like a lighthouse thing set as reference. What is that? Set as reference layer? My pen isn't. Yeah, set as reference layer. I just call it the lighthouse thingy. Because I love it, because you can do this. Wow. You hit the bucket once, and then it just fills in. You know, so it makes... I mean, you don't got to use the magic wand. You could do it with just the line art layer, but there... I know that there are features that exist that I yet comprehend. You know what I'm saying? Because there's ways when you bucket fill, you can get the bucket fill to overfill. So that it, it stops right at where the lines are at. You know, it's not, if I make this transparent, it doesn't cross that line whatsoever. So there's a way to get it to overfill. I just don't know what it's called. Right, hold on. Is it, what is it? Window, subtool, no, it's subtool something, right? Subtool view? Oh no, that's that. I really don't know much about what I'm using here. This. I have, and I learned, and I forgot. That's ultimately what happened. I got, because it's like subtle detail. There we go. All right. Brings up this thing. Reference? Maybe? Multiple referring with. I'm gonna use my mouse and stop filling at center line of vector. Could that be it? Let's see what that does. Ooh, no! Don't fill there. Fill here. Fill here. Let's even have a play around layer. Did that overfill at all? Only a tiny bit. So maybe it's not the stop filling. Include central line. Include central line, lines drawn, vector on filling. It just doesn't seem to change anything. I don't know what I'm doing. Reference layer, reference draw frame, reference drawn frame is outer perimeter. Do not start filling this color. Anti-aliasing, ink opacity, blah blah blah. I think it has something to do with fill. It is off. Target same color and layer. Close gap. from on the end. Well, yeah, because there's a style, and it's got to fit that style, and yeah, you have a very different art style in general. Well, I don't stick to one solid art style. I think that's it. It's overfilling just a tad. But you know what? I think that's cool. I'm gonna undo that, and I'm gonna try to do this. Cause there's a way, right? Like if I don't do the outline. What? What happened there? Okay, let me. No, not the same layer. Yeah, let me just. Like, this is just using the normal line layer. But see how, like, I gotta keep clicking? You know, because it stops. It always stops at certain areas. I mean, it's cool, but since I this art style uses the outline anyway, you know? Oh, I gotta turn that later on. Oops. You know, since it uses the outline layer as part of the style, that's what I used to fill in. You know, but that doesn't matter because that layer is just for funzoids. I got a flat layer, I got this layer. What color should I actually make this mecha? Cool. Very cool gray. So a heavy blue for the shoulder, really. Keep it gray, right? Heavy but cool gray. Let's try that. This way we have the blues for the grays. And you want heavy, dark ones is what you're talking about, right? When you mention heavy. Sir, yes, sir. Just gonna. Oh, I got this sub tool view thing open on another screen, bugging me out. So, is this my time to hang out with the lurkers? Hello, lurkers. How are you? I hope you're enjoying what you're saying. Or you're just hanging out with me and watching the crazy. Watching Brian make me crazy is what you're doing. If anybody knows about metal, what color is hardened steel? Like, does it have a very specific color? Or can it be other colors? Like if no pigment or anything was used in the forging or whatever. Raw, just hardened steel. Just curious, like, I wonder, should I do this color too? Like, the sort of hunchback area? Not different enough in color. Most people won't be able to see that. Even that's not that different in color. Right there, some flat gray. No cold, no warmth. Just flat unpigmented gray for that piece. For this series, for his midsection.
Maybe for this too. Yeah. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna put everything in a folder, is what I'm gonna do. And then I'm gonna duplicate that folder somewhere. Am I duplicating that in its own thing? No, okay. So this way I can just play around with something entirely different. So we could have this brush. This wall. No. Oh, it'd have to be airbrush. Like, hard. Let's see. Maybe I should just do it in pen and blur it afterwards. I think that's what I'll do.
Yeah. I got that noise in my head. Okay, brother, you are back, you have returned, and it is a pleasure to see you back here. So, hello, how are you doing? I hear some sold ears. Glug, 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 glug. Oh, those are just... Yeah. Let's not gauzy and blur them that much. It's a little one. Unpro-whatable? Unpro-nothingable. It's just we can't see it. See, that's not so bad. Let's see if I do that and then do putting it in. 5 pixels? Ooh, the 5 pixels is a lot for this size. Alright, so let's draw it in by 2 pixels and let's give it like a very... that color, right? Deselect, maybe even Gaussian that a bit, because Gaussian blur is such an amazing friend. Hello, Gauss. No, it's too much. Actually, let's cancel. Let's duplicate that really quick. I want to try something. This would be so much easier in Photoshop, like effects. Special effects. Damn it, Photoshop has got that kind of on lock, as far as I'm concerned. Or as far as I know. Alright, so don't know what I'm looking at, but see over here, it's a little incoherent. Here it's all right because enough of it was large enough, and over here it's too much. Maybe I need to come up in here and be like,
hey, you guys, look, we have a little more in the lighting.
Like that. I'm a jest. I don't know what I am. I'm what you call liberated. No, I said I'm what you call a liberated. No, liberated. Because the liberation is mental in nature. Does not mean I'm crazy. I'm mentally liberated. Liberated in all mental capacity or lack thereof. Because stuff's... Whatever, man. Oh, that's lighter than that. Oh, okay. Oh, wow. All right.
Holy Mazola oil.
Holy sprockets.
Holy rusty sprockets, Batman. I've discovered a plot and scheme against the stuff. Yeah, a good sidekick.
Yes, Robin. Been a good sidekick for the past 35 years.
But I'm only 17.
You're not the first.
What? And I thought I was special. What happened to the other Robins, Batman?
They died.
They did, though. Like, how many Robins died? Batman sucks as a superhero. He can't even save his own sidekicks. Like, I'm gonna... Huh? Yo, one of his sidekicks, like one of the Robins, if I remember correctly, died, was brought back from the dead, brainwashed, and became like a villainistic vigilante. Jason Todd, was it? I can't remember. I know it was whoever ended up becoming the Red Hood. Yeah, that was Jason Todd. Right?
You have to get the Joker out of your head, boy. Because Batman said so. I'm Batman.
If you ever wanted to do a Batman impersonation, just pretend to be taking a dump while you talk. I should shut up. Don't listen to me at all. Don't don't listen to me at all. I'm a bad influence. I'm a bad influence. I'm a very bad influence.
I'm a bad boy. I'm a bad boy. Are you a bad boy, Batman? Well, pleasure to find out.
Why are we picking on Batman? What did you start, Brian? You know, because you're hanging out with me here and not in chat today, I have no proof to share with the world that you are the instigator of this. You slick. You villain, you. Look. You were scared. I saw the look on your face, man. You're like, I got the proof. It was in the hangout. Not the hangout. It was in the broadcast. He was chatting. And it's like, oh, the broadcast didn't record. What the hell? Because I didn't know I was doing something wrong. Because that was my very first broadcast. So you lucked out is what happened. You lucked out. You only say that now. After the fact, because the proof mysteriously disappeared. I don't know. You might have. I'm not gonna name any names, Brian, but you might have. Yeah. Well, look, McCallus, should that be like white line shine or that light blue? Nah, cause like I want it to be like that. You know, this is where the shine. I want that shine to be there because, like, it's that polished, sharpened edge for cutting McCallus's wings off, both of them in one swipe. I don't know what you do, McCallus. What did you do to this poor little gnome? Did you joke about his size? Were you criticizing his size again, McCallus? Like you were insinuating that size plays a part in Marshall's skill. Like that did not bode well for the gnome. Like that gnome, he's a lieutenant in a fast. Well, had someone carry the conversation on long enough and placate the Tau Samat until the gnome came back into the barracks, you know, could have been a different story. No, I'm talking about before that. You know what I'm saying? Like, when, yeah, because he was trying to get that dope, is what it was. He's trying to get that dope. He was like, yeah, anybody want to play some cards? I won't cheat you at all, I swear. Where's my pen? Right here? Alright.
Get the van in. Michigan, yeah.
I'm just cell shading and making a mockery of singing. So no good, haha, king.
Like a struggling doctor, no patience. Quiet, because I'm like concentrating on cell shading. This, yeah, you were asking about like the method in which I draw, like the method in which this art style is. It's just, you know, you draw your line art, like you saw how it started off, right? Like the real sketchy nature of it. So it's like drawing a sketch. Well, that's just the cell shading. Multiplying. It's just a layer above the color. Anywhere above the color. Like, this is cell shading. You see this weird sort of very, very desaturated and very light blue color? This is the color I usually use. Sometimes I go to a purple version, like a very desaturated purple for skin. That's what I did when we were doing the King's Blood performer. The cool shading didn't really work with her skin. So purple being sort of a compromise between warmer and cooler colors. And you put it somewhere above, and then you just hit ta-dung, multiply, and then now you're shading. It's the cell shading is pretty simple. That's it. And it comes from one angle, the light source. So the light source hits from one angle only. So you're not shading multiple areas. Right? So it's coming up and from the right for this guy. You could make some compromises in reality, you know, some nonsensical choices for style, just to sort of push form or just the look of it a little bit. Because right now, I mean, with the thing glowing and the, you know, that's multiple light sources. So proper shading would dictate you need to shade for multiple light sources. But here it's just the one. You know, like if I wanted, this has like a lip right here. On the other side, I shaded the lip. So here, I'll shade not the lip. I'll shade everything else about it. Right? It makes a little bit of sense. Not very much sense if you know what you're doing as far as actual lighting. But because of the cartoon nature of it, I think it helps it. Like, I like the way it looks stylistically for SMTT.
You know, now I'm just erasing some of the cell shading on the spikes because they'd sort of be raised high enough. You know? To catch some of the light. You know what I'm saying? So everything, like this whole area, would be in the shadow because it's like underneath a bunch of crap. Right? And this would start off in the shaded area and reveal itself to be not a shaded area. Dun, dun. Because this entire underside would be shaded. Because, you know, it's like a cuboid. So it wouldn't catch any of the light from where it is. Or maybe I should just... Yeah, I think I'll do that. Here's where I make a little bit of concession in reality. Because this right here is curved. This area would theoretically catch the light. Right? But I want to follow that line up this way. You know? Huh? Oh! Hello, everybody! Feel free to engage in chat. Ask me any questions you want. I'm here. But yeah, like, I'll make the concession in the light source a little bit. You know? To not make sense, just because I like the way it looks stylistically. You know, it helps sell the different sort of change in form. Like back here, the entire thumb is going to be cell shaded. Even. See what I'm fiddling with? Let me save it while I'm at it. Let me have a drink is what I'll do. Some of that life-giving precious water, baby. So I'm go back in there and keep cell shading, you know. So it's like a stylistic choice. Like, you know, here wouldn't catch the light, right? But if you notice the sword, you see how I got like that shine. That's a little nonsensical. Yeah, but you see what I'm saying? If there is, then this area I just shaded would be catching some of that light source. So it's a bit nonsensical. Actually, you know what? I want to keep that glowing bit above it. So I'll just put the cell shading layer below it. So yeah, some of the choices are made just for style. You know? And that much I can't necessarily share with you. Because you gotta make that when you're doing it, you know? When do you break the rules? Yeah. Because this doesn't make any sense. But that's the cartoony... You know, that's that cartoony, oh my gosh, this is sharp look. You know? So I want that to be there. Because, oh my gosh, this is sharp. though it doesn't make any sense because there's very little light it'd be catching. It'd have to be catching light from that direction. You know, so maybe a little bit of sense, but not really. But who cares? I mean, it looks cool. Like, that's the point of the SMTT. It's mostly gotta look pretty cool and cartoony. And remind you of those cartoons back in the day. That, yeah, they didn't really make sense. Like, nothing they did really made sense. You know, I might shade in between those lines to make it look a little bit more divoted. Like heavy cable almost. Like it's ribbed. I'll I got a joke. I'm not going there. I'm not going there. Like, okay, this is like a little... These are little divots. So I might throw a little shading in there to sell that they're divots. This is the other side of his face. Be kind of out of... You know, the light. And then we got this thing that kind of like bulges out. Not that the robot needs it, but it's there. And then we go back to here. Like, this is bent inwards, so it'll be shaded. And then I'm crossing over there, and I probably shouldn't be, but. It'll get harder over here because this is a plane and this is a plane, you know? So if that plane pops out, this would be the one that gets the shading, but that one's below the light, so it wouldn't, you know? And then that would cast a shadow a little bit over there. This would be kind of weirdish, but not so much. I'll erase, you know, whatever I go over, because I know where I want that line to be, because I drew it there, yay! And then we gotta put a little divot here because of the chest plates. You know, they're casting a little bit of a shadow themselves. This is like that funk, man. Oh. I erased it too much. What will I do? I'll put it back. That's what I'll do. That's kind of like the, you know, the rules to the SMTT cell shading. You know, that and that thick outline, like, that speaks cartoony to me. So, you know, I think that's important to have in the SMTT stuff, is that thick... That weird thick outline. This would cast a shadow over here. The arms. And oddly enough, this would be in its own shadow. Like this glowy bits. So let's put it in shadow. You know? There you go. And they kind of look better in the shadow. Alright, so this would be all in shade, because that's like a thing. And kind of the whole fist, actually. Like, what part of that fist would catch light? I mean, don't give me that bounce light stuff. No, there's no bounce lighting. We're not calculating bounce lighting for SMTT. Or maybe we should, like, right there. Just a little bit, maybe. Yeah, let me zoom out. So I keep mentioning SMTT. So for those of you that are watching, basically that's an RPG rule set that I designed. That's based on, you know, old school cartoon action and just utter fantasy wackiness. And, you know, if you want to check it out, you can go to drivethrurpg.com. I got it up for sale. I have the beginner rules that are for free so that you can check out the basics of the rules. However, the full product is fully bookmarked. With the magic and gear section actually being hyperlinked. So, you know, arcane power tubes, you don't know what they are, you click them, it drops you to the description of the arcane power tubes. Same thing goes for the magic section. If you want to go for a spells. Oh, the races of SMTT? Good God. Okay, character creation. The races. We have the races of SMTT currently. These are all the character choices for when you want to play a game of SMTT. So we start off with the caretakers, which are the living constructs of the game. The crystal caretaker is, of course, made of crystal. The tinkered caretaker is made of gadgety goodness. We have the changelings, hiding in a barrel because changelings, you never know what they're going to be. They can change shape. So they're the shape changers of the game. We have the Divi Savayang, which are the cat people of the game. There's the Daitora, who's an actual full-blown cat, who grows in size as they age, eventually becoming large beasts. The Nekahito, which are the very humanoid cats that can kind of, they have their little, you know, kitty rage. The Kyojin, which are the Wemmicks. We have normal dwarves. We have beast dwarves. They're like lycanthropic dwarves. The normal magic-casting elf. The Moonglade Wanderer, or the Shadow Elf. You know, they dip in and out of shadows. The Frost Goblins, the poor cursed Frost Goblins, were children kidnapped at birth by the Frost Goblin King and cursed by the Frost Goblin King's curse to grow up to become Frost Goblins. We've got the two different gnomes, the Tinker Gnome, which is the technological badass, and then the Gremlins. Yeah, that's a... Oh, what's her name again? That's Mustachio, Captain Augustus Mustachio, and that's Nyxlax. There you go. That's Nyxlax, the Gremlin Ranger. Then we've got our obligatory half-orc. Halfling. The Nazari Halfling is a pretty traditional sort of backstabbing bastard. Then we have the Nimrigar, which, you know, they eat anything made of meat. Humans, because you need humans in every fantasy thing. The King's Blood, which are the glowy kind of people, descended from a god. And currently, the cult of the Sky King is, if you don't know what that is, you can check out on my YouTube the Hero School campaign. We have the Reavers, which are the amphibious reptiloid things, which are, they're actually born of 1,000 souls, so they are the descended children of basically mortal demons. Then there's the SMTT Orc. They're more gorilla-like in this game, but they're just as big, beefy, and beat-em-uppy. Then we have the Wild Men, the Yeti, the Tau Samat, which is a walrus man, the Oni, which is a cyclops, and the Ogre, because where would you be in a game without a big, burly ogre, right? Those are all the races of Saturday morning tabletop. And eventually, golem armor pilots, which are going to be the mechas of SMTT when I finish designing the rules. Now that I took a moment to stop yammering, I'm hearing the song. This is a good song. This is a good remix. No, no, no. Rehab. No, no, no. So I'm confused as to this should be the area in shade for this leg, right? Yeah. This would be the area in shade. Because this would be by the actual light source. Weird thing is that would this be or would this be or would it all be just all in shadow like in the Gladiator movie? We are nothing but shadows and dust. Put some shady bits on the scratches he has. Some of the scratches anyway, like they're dents and stuff. You know, I think it'd look cool for this if we do this. You know, for like, yeah, but also allowing like the light to catch off and some of the shady bits. Yeah, I think for the most part, that's kind of done. Now I think I get to be silly. You want to be silly, Brian? Let's be silly. Let's make a mask of... Alright. Let's just do this temporarily. I want to do that. Then I want to do this. And... how do I delete everything on it? No, I gotta invert the selection, right? That's this button, and then I hit delete. Alright. So, deselect, make that into its own mask, and delete all the stuff inside. Right? Awesome! Oh, no. I deleted the mask and not the colors. I want to delete the colors. Alright, so I hit brush twice. Maybe go to the softer of the airbrushes. And let's get some of that bright light blue. Right. You know what I'm saying, Brian? It's like that blue is kind of catching off. You know? Some of the areas, I mean, I could lower the opacity of it so it's not as strong. Purposely put it on there just a little bit stronger. Maybe get some dark blue to represent how it's like, you know, how the color sort of fades away. Some of the areas, maybe a little bit of, just a little bit there. I gotta have a little bit of that brighter blue right here because that light is there. Play around with the opacity a little. See, and that's one of those little silly concessions just to make it look a little cooler. So how does that look? So should that one be called done? Let's see, what I do today? I got PDFs, Golem, Let's take that off the screen because we don't need that on the screen. We got. Alright, so what we got done today. Let us share with the interwebs. We have the creature that Knuckles became. All four draconic wings, weaponized tail, his claws, and the mechanical-esque claw. Also, Ryan, when talking about the concessions earlier, you notice how I have like a little bit of highlight in here? You know, just in the scale, because you would figure scales kind of catch highlights a little bit more than skin would. And just a little bit of that shine on those gems and on his teeth. You know, just not always, but sometimes it's cool. And then, you know, Knuckles is missing that tooth, so too is this form. Yeah, so that was Knuckles. And this is the Golem armor. That was doing. Golem armor coming soon.
to a game of Saturday Morning Tabletop near you.
Yeah. Oh, do my stretching. You think I should draw the pilot too? What? What is the pilot gonna be? Oh, you know you're gonna make me do it, aren't you? Nah, they don't need a helmet. Like, they get a suit, but they don't need a helmet. Okay, you don't have to be a little baby about it. Jeez. Let's see, I've been here 3 hours already, but I did manage to eat before coming here, so that's good. With Mike? I do have to do this. I do have to prep for it too. I got some, is Mike even online? Let's see. He doesn't look online. All right. Yeah, I think you know what? The smarter thing would be to end the stream now and go prep for that that game. So, for those of you that have been watching, I don't know if you read the updates below, tomorrow is a planned blackout. My building is shutting down the power to do some form of upgrades or whatever to the electrical system. So, the planned blackout is supposedly from like 11 to 1. So I may not be able to do a stream since, you know, I start at 10. So unfortunately that's probably not going to happen, and depending on the length of the that blackout, you know, if they operate according to schedule, I can come back and run some games. If not, I don't know what, you know, what to do. So I probably won't be streaming tomorrow, but I will be streaming Tuesday. So for all of you ladies and gentlemen who have dropped by, spend some time with me and Brian, who's in my ears right now, you know, thanks for watching, for putting up with my insanity, and I'll see you next time. Peace.